Hello friends, welcome to Tutorial Hub. This is our fourth lecture of percentage series. In this lecture, I'm gonna tell you about a very important concept related to percentage problems, and that is product constancy. You'll find lots of questions related to this concept in different exams. So what is product constancy? We will understand it using an example. Suppose an apple price is 1.25. So in 20 unit we can buy 16 apple because 1.25 multiplied by 16 is equal to 20. And if the price of apple is decreased by 0.25, then we can buy 20 apple in 20 rupee, right? Because now one apple cost 1, so 20 apple will cost 20. So if you notice, our total money is constant in this expression. Price multiplied by number of apple equal to total money, and we changed our product in a way that our total money not get affected. So that is product constancy. But now you will think how it is related to percentage problem. Okay, see this question. Our question is, the price of rice is increased by 25%, then by how much percent should you reduce the consumption of rice so that you have not to increase your expenses on rice? Okay, we know price multiplied by quantity is equal to expenditure. Here price is getting increased and we want our expenditure to be constant. So that means we need to decrease our quantity used. Okay, suppose rice price is 100 and we are using 100 units. So our expenditure is 10,000, and according to question, price is increased by 25%, and we know 25% of 100 is 25. So new price is 125, and new quantity we need to find. So assume the new quantity is X, and we need to our expenditure to be constant. So put it same as 10,000. And after solving this equation, we get 80. So that means reduction is 100 minus 80 equal to 20%. And that is our answer. Okay, so that's how we can solve these questions. Even we can remember some tricks that I am showing you in next slide to calculate the answer in less time. Okay, the trick is, when one factor of a product is increased by X percent, then the other factor will be decreased by X upon 100 plus X multiplied by 100%. And if suppose a factor is decreased by X percent, then other factor of product will be increased by X upon 100 minus X and multiplied by 100%. Even we can express it in the form of fraction. Like if a factor of a product is increased by P by Q, then we need to decrease other factor by P by Q plus P, and if one factor is decreased by P by Q, then we just need to put a minus sign here to get formula for increase other factor. And that's the all conclusion that we can use in product constancy type questions. Okay, let's apply this conclusion to given question. Given question is, if the price of a petrol falls down by 20%, then by how much percent a person should increase its consumption so as not to decrease the expenditure on this item? Okay, as we know, consumption multiplied by price is equal to expenditure, and we want expenditure to be constant. So it is a product constancy type of question, and here one factor is getting decreased, so we need to use increase formula. Actually, I always prefer fraction formula because it's easy to use. We have given 20% decrease, and 20% is equal to 1/5. So we need to increase other factor by 1/5 minus 1, which is equal to 1/4, and that is equal to 25%. So person need to increase use of petrol by 25% more. So you can see it took only 4 to 5 seconds to solve this type of question by using our conclusion. So okay guys, that's it for today's lecture. If you want PDF of this lecture for notes purpose, you can drop me a mail on tutorialhub11@gmail.com. You can follow this channel on Twitter. Please like Facebook page of this channel for important updates about upcoming videos, and I have provided all the links in description below. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, please thumbs up and subscribe for more videos. This is Adi, your tutor, signing off. Bye-bye.